Welcome to the lecture titled Model Based PIPD Controller Design. In this lecture, we will study the design of a proportional integral proportional derivative controller. So, there will be two controllers in the loop to control either stable or unstable or integrating processes. The benefit of using PIPD controller has been described in one of our previous lectures. Now, PIPD structure is the commonly used configuration, which is a 2 degree of freedom and 4 parameter controller. Unlike the SISO controller, many SISO controllers we have discussed in our previous lectures, PIPD control structure is a 2 degree of freedom control structure. PIPD controller parameters will be designed for a first order plus dead time transfer function model, where we will assume the transfer function model to be of the form g s is equal to k e to the power minus theta s upon t 1 s plus minus 1. And to find design parameters or controller parameters for an integrating process, limiting values for t 1 can be applied when t 1 tends to infinity, such that k upon t 1 is finite, can be used to find integrating process model, or the formulae will derive for the PIPD controllers will be made applicable for integrating processes as well. Now, how will identify the transfer function model of a dynamics? First, we will employ a relay, an ideal relay in parallel with the PI controller, and of course, the PD controller will be present during the relay experiment. So, this is the scheme that is going to be used for identification for estimation of first order plus dead time transfer function model for the dynamics of the real time process. M stands for the measurement noise, and L stands for the static load disturbance. Now, how the online tuning will be done? Initially, an ideal relay will be connected in parallel with a PI controller, and limit cycle will be induced. Limit cycle output will be obtained, and from the measurements made on the limit cycle output, parameters of the transfer function model, basically k, theta and t 1 will be estimated. Now, I will describe little bit of the equivalent block diagram we will have for the online tuning structure, what the relay sees basically. So, we will go for the equivalent block diagram, where we can represent the earlier block diagram in the form of a block diagram having relay in the feed forward path and the real time process dynamics available also in the forward path, whereas both the controller dynamics will be present in the inner feedback path. Now, we will have g c 1 s plus g c 2 s here, where this is the dynamics of p I controller. Therefore, we will have p I plus p d controller, p I, let me write the p I plus p d controller over here. So, we will have p I plus p d controller in the inner feedback path. So, this is what the relay sees during relay test. Now, the relay will be subjected to some modified process given by g dash s is equal to g s divided by 1 plus g s times the dynamics of the p I plus p d controller, and that will be nothing but your g c 1 s plus g c 2 s. So, this is what a relay sees. So, the identification will be carried out for this modified process, from where again it will be possible to estimate the parameters of the transfer function model for a dynamic system GS, since we know GC1S and GC2S. How you know GC1S and GC2S? When you are commissioning a process initially, you may have no information about the controller parameters. That requires us to go for the choice of start controllers to initiate relay test at the beginning. Let the forms of the PI and PD controllers be GC1S is equal to KP times 1 plus 1 upon TIS, and GC2S is equal to KF times 1 plus TDS upon 1 plus beta TDS. Normally, beta is chosen a very small value. When beta is equal to 0.01, we can neglect the derivative filter term from our subsequent analysis. So, GC2 can be written as KF times 1 plus TDS for analysis, for each in analysis in our subsequent dealing of the analytical expressions. Now, the relay is actually GC1S plus GC2S in the inner feedback path that I have described, of course, assuming the R is equal to 0. When R is not equal to 0, also you can draw an equivalent block diagram, and from there also you can find that the relay is basically the PI plus PD controller present in the inner feedback path. Now, to initiate the relay test, when no information about the process dynamics is available, we have to make some choices for the controller parameters. Now, the PI controller parameters can be set as KP as a value from 0.01 to 0.1. So, choose a value from 0.01 to 0.1 for the proportional gain of the PI controller, and the TI is chosen as 1. And at that time, the PD controller is said to be 0. That means, the gain of the PD controller KF is assumed to be 0. This is what you are required to choose initially when you have no information about the process dynamics and you have no default values for the PI PD controller. Then, with these initial choices, a relay test is conducted and process model parameters are estimated. Then, the PI PD controller parameters are updated based on the process model parameters. We will develop the PI PD tuning formulae, which can be used to update its parameters using the information we get from the process model, and then PI PD controller parameters are updated before the second stage of relay test. So, another relay test is required to estimate the parameters of the first order plus dead time model using describing function. Then you will get some accurate estimation for the first order plus dead time transfer function model. So, two stages of relay tests are conducted to find the model parameters. Now, I will begin with the design of PD controller. We will now discuss about the way the PI PD controller parameters can be tuned, or we will now develop analytical expressions for the parameters of the PI and PD controllers. So, to begin with, I will choose again the process dynamics given by GS is equal to K e to the power minus theta s upon T 1 s plus minus 1. Now, the controller GC2S, this is the PD controller, is described by KF times 1 plus TDS. Therefore, we will get some, due to the inner feedback controller GC2 in the PI PD control structure, please look at the PI PD control structure. When there is no relay in the loop, then the process is subjected to a PD controller and due to that the PD controller will form some modified process given by G dash S, as already I have told. Now, that G dash S, the modified process, the modified process dynamics can be expressed as G S divided by 1 plus G S G C 2 S, giving us k e to the power minus theta s divided by t 1 s plus minus 1 divided by 1 plus k e to the power minus theta s divided by t 1 s plus minus 1. So, 1 minus is here, plus minus 1 times k f 1 plus t d s. So, let us simplify this expression for designing the PD controller. So, G D S is now k e to the power minus theta s divided by T 1 s plus minus 1 plus k k f e to the power minus theta s times 1 plus T D S. Okay. Now, I will use Pede estimation or approximation for the time delay term for further simplification of the modified process. What is Pede approximation? We know that Pede approximation for time delay is found in the form of e to the power minus theta by 2 s divided by 1 plus e to the power, sorry, not 1 plus, divided by e to the power theta by 2 s, which can be further extended in the form of 1 minus theta by 2 s divided by 1 plus theta by 2 s. So, using that, the modified process dynamics becomes k e to the power minus theta s divided by t 1 s plus minus 1 plus k k f times 1 minus theta by 2 s in the numerator and 1 plus theta by 2 s in the denominator. So, I have substituted the time delay term by the Pede approximation, giving us an expression of this form 1 plus T d s. So, when T d is equated to theta by 2, with the choice of the derivative time constant for the P d controller we have in the PI P d control structure, T d h theta by 2, G dash s reduces to a form k e to the power minus theta s T 1 s plus minus 1 plus k k f times 1 minus theta by 2 s, which can further be written in the form of k e to the power minus theta s divided by T 1 minus k k f theta by 2 times s plus k k f plus minus 1. Okay. So, the modified process is given by this expression, this transfer function. Now, what information you get from this modified transfer function? If you carefully look the denominator of this transfer function, the modified process will be stable. For stability of the modified process, for stability of the modified process, we need to have k k f is greater than 1, because minus 1 is there. So, unless k k f is greater than 1, you do not get a positive constant over here or coefficient over here. So, k k f has to be greater than equal to 1. Similarly, if you look at the first term, the coefficient of the first term, this has to be a positive value, and for that what has to happen? K k f has to be less than 2 t 1 by theta. So, when k k f is less than 2 t 1 by theta, then we will get a positive coefficient in the denominator for the first term, and when all the coefficients are positive, we ensure that the modified process is stable, or the dynamics of the modified process will be a stable dynamics. Okay. So, the second condition is that KKF has to be less than equal to KKF has to be less than equal to 2T1 by theta. So, 2T1 by theta. When I club together these two inequalities or requirements, what I get? KKF is less than equal to KF which, oh, okay. So, KKF is less than equal to 1 is less than equal to 2T1 by theta. So, this is the requirement. Since KKF has to be greater than equal to 1 and KKF has to be less than equal. Okay. So, when I put the two conditions together, KKF has to be greater than equal to, okay, so the two conditions KKF will be greater than equal to 1, definitely KKF. So, this is the inequalities you will get corresponding to the two requirement. So, when this is satisfied or when the two conditions are put together, we need that KKF has to be a value less than equal to 1, not less than equal to 1, rather let me put it in an explicit form. It is not clear. So, basically this requires KF has to be greater than equal to 1 by K and another we have got KKF, sorry, KKF here. So, KF is to be less than equal to 2T1 by K theta. Now, I will put these two requirements in the form of 1 upon k is less than equal to k f is less than equal to 2T1 by k theta. Now, it is correct. Okay. So, if you look at carefully, when this is met, when k k f is greater than 1, indirectly speaking, k f is greater than equal to 1 by k or 1 by k is less than equal to k f. Okay. It is correct now. Is again k f is less than equal to 2T1 by k theta. Then we get an inequality of this form. Now, how to find the KF value? If I take the geometric progression of the two, so 1 upon k times 2T1 upon k theta root. So, if I use that, when I use the geometric mean for this one, I can find a value for KF which can ultimately be given by 1 upon k, because k square is there, root of 2T1 by theta. So, this is how we do estimate one parameter of the controller GC2S. Okay. So, both the parameters of the PID controller have been designed now. Let me rewrite again the PD controller parameters. So, the PD controller parameters are KF is equal to 1 upon k root of 2T1 by theta and TD is equal to theta by 2. Because we know that the PD controller GC2S, which is nothing but a PD controller, has got the dynamics KF times 1 plus TDS. Thus, both the parameters of the PD controller are designed using, of course, the parameters of a transfer function model. What are the parameters of a transfer function model? T1 k theta. So, therefore, in terms of the model parameters, we will be able to design the PD controller. Now, we will go to the design of a PI controller. So, design of PI controller. How the PI controller looks like? For us, GC1S is equal to KP times 1 plus 1 upon TIS, which can ultimately be written as KP times TIS plus 1 divided by TIS. So, this is the PI controller. So, design of PI controller means now we will derive explicit expressions for the KP and TI. the proportional gain and the time constant associated with the PI controller in terms of the model parameters, that means T1, theta and K, or K, theta and T1. Now, to design, to proceed with the design of PI controller, let me rewrite the modified process with respect to which we will be designing the PI controller. How the loop looks like now? So, we have got reference input here and a PI controller in the loop GC1S subjected to the modified process. Please keep in mind, we have the modified process in the loop now. So, designing controller for this, will require us to consider the loop gain. Using the phase margin and gain margin criteria, it is possible to design the parameters of the PI controller. The way phase and gain margin criteria can be applied has been discussed already in our previous lecture. I will extend the same to design PI controller for the PIPD control structure. Okay? Now, I will consider the GDS modified process, which is given as now GDS is now K e to the power minus theta s upon T 1 minus K K f theta by 2 s plus K K f plus minus 1. So, I am rewriting the modified process. Please keep in mind, the PI controller will be designed with respect to the modified process, and the modified process is derived as this. Now, this can further be simplified and written in the form of k divided by k k f plus minus 1 e to the power minus theta s divided by T 1 minus k k f theta by 2 divided by k k f plus minus 1 s plus 1, giving us a transfer function of the form k dash e to the power minus theta s upon tau s plus 1, okay? Where k dash is how much? K divided by k k f plus minus 1 and tau is equal to T 1 minus k k f theta by 2 divided by k k f plus minus 1. Why I am doing so? I can get rid of the plus minus sign associated with the modified process. Okay? So, we have found the PI controller to be of the form GC1S is equal to K P T I S plus 1 divided by T I S, and the modified process in the form of k dash e to the power minus theta s upon tau s plus 1. Now, the loop gain of the control loop is g c 1 s times g dash s. In the frequency domain, the loop gain will be GC1 j omega g dash j omega. Substitute s by j omega simply, then you get the frequency domain representation of the loop gain. So, g c 1 j omega g dash j omega will be equal to k p j omega t I plus 1 divided by j omega t I times k dash e to the power minus j omega theta divided by j omega tau plus 1. So, this loop gain in frequency domain will be used for designing the parameters of the PI controller. Now, let us make the gain margin criterion for designing the parameters of the PI controller. So, using the gain margin criterion, what is the gain margin criterion? we know that at the phase crossover frequency, at the phase crossover frequency omega p, loop gain will have a magnitude of inverse of gain margin. So, GC1 j omega p g dash j omega p g dash j omega p magnitude will be 1 by gain margin, okay. And the phase angle of the loop gain at that frequency will be minus 180 degree or minus pi. So, using the two, I will be designing the parameter, the parameters of the PI controller. So, what is the loop gain now? GC1 j omega p g dash j omega p is equal to, if you look at Kp, Kp j omega p Ti, Ti plus 1 by j omega p Ti into k e to the power minus j omega p theta divided by j omega p j omega p tau plus 1. Now, if I look at carefully the loop gain at this phase crossover frequency, we have scope for cancelling one pole with one zero. So, this pole can be cancelled with this zero with the choice of T I is equal to tau. So, when the PI controller time constant is equated to tau, when T I equal to tau, then we will have this cancellation giving us the loop gain as K K P e to the power minus j omega p theta divided by j omega p tau, because Ti is now equal to tau. So, I will use this loop gain now with the choice of Ti is equal to tau and apply the condition gain margin criterion to find the controller parameter Kp. Okay? So, using the two conditions, I can write the gain condition will result in K K P omega p tau, K K P by omega p tau will be equal to 1 by gain margin, and using the phase condition minus pi by 2 minus omega p theta is equal to minus pi. So, the first one gives us omega p is equal to K K P by G M, sorry, K K P G M by tau. So, it will give omega p is equal to K K P G M by tau, and the second one will give you omega p is equal to pi by 2 theta. Okay? So, equating the two omega p's now, you get K K P G M by tau is equal to pi by 2 theta. Yes. So, you will get K P is equal to, K P is equal to pi by 2 theta K G M tau. So, final expression for the K P is the gain of the P I controller, the proportional gain of the P I controller K P H pi tau by 2 theta K G M. So, when you have got information or when user defined the gain margin is used, it is possible to estimate the proportional gain of the PI controller. And whatever the remaining parameter of the PI controller, we have already taken Ti h tau. So, in terms of the plant parameters, the PI controller parameters are estimated. What are the plant parameters? Tau is the plant parameter. Now, theta is the plant parameter, K is the plant parameter. Now, if you substitute tau now here, then what you will get? The tau by K will give you pi by 2 theta gm. Please keep in mind, I have got k dash. I am making some mistake because the loop gain has got kp, kp, k dash. Please keep in mind, here we have got k dash. So, I have to make use of k dash, not k. So, it will give k dash, k dash. Okay? So, please make this correction, k will be k dash, k dash. So, that way we will have k dash over here. So, in place of k, we will have k dash, but we know that tau upon k dash will be simply your t 1 minus k k f theta by 2 divided by k dash is k by k k f plus minus 1. So, k k f plus minus 1 is there in the denominator of both terms. So, finally, k p expression for k p will be this one, which is in terms of the Plant model parameters. Okay. Now, I will use the phase margin criterion to find the PI controller parameters. Again, the loop gain in frequency domain is found to be kp j omega t I plus 1 divided by j omega t I into k dash. Please keep in mind, we have got k dash minus j omega theta divided by j omega tau plus 1. Okay. So, choose like the earlier case, choose t I is equal to tau, giving the loop gain h, loop gain. Now, it becomes the loop gain becomes g c 1 j omega g dash j omega is equal to, with the cancellation of this choice, you have got k dash k p e to the power minus j omega theta divided by j omega t I. So, what is the phase margin gives us at the gain crossover frequency? At the gain crossover frequency, at the gain crossover frequency omega g, we get g c 1 j omega g g dash j omega g magnitude is equal to 1 and pi plus angle of g c 1 j omega g g dash j omega g is equal to the phase margin. Okay. So, using that, I will get the 2h. Now, this will give you, let me write here the magnitude of this function at frequency omega g will give us k dash k p by omega g tau is equal to 1. And the second one will give you pi plus phase angle of this one will be minus 90 degree due to this j. So, minus pi by 2 minus omega g theta is equal to phi m. So, what I have got? K dash k p by omega g, k dash k p by omega g tau is equal to 1 and pi by 2 minus omega g theta, pi by 2 minus omega g theta is equal to the phase margin. Now, from the first one, again we get omega g is equal to k dash k p by tau, and the second one we will get omega g h pi by 2 minus phi m by theta. Okay. So, pi by 2 minus phi m by theta. So, now equate the two omega g. So, then you will get k dash k p by tau is equal to pi by 2 minus phi m by theta, or k p h pi by 2 minus phi m by, not phi, theta, by theta into tau by k dash. Now, tau by k dash can be substituted and we will get the final expression for the proportional gain of the PIE controller as pi by 2 minus phi m times T 1 minus k k f theta by 2 divided by k. So, this is how the proportional gain of the PIE controller can be designed using the phase margin criterion. So, we have developed two formulae, one for the same gain controller of the PIE controller using the phase margin condition and using the gain margin condition. When the two expression for K p are observed carefully, then what do you find? You find interestingly when K p of the design methods are considered, then what do we get? We get a relationship of the form pi by 2 minus phase margin divided by theta is equal to pi by 2 theta g m. Cancel the two. So, you get ultimately an relation of the form phase margin is equal to pi by 2 will be common. So, 1 minus 1 by gain margin. So, this is what you get. So, there is direct relationship between the phase and gain margins given by this. So, when you choose different gain margin equal to 2, that time phase margin will be equal to pi by 4, which is equal to 45 degree. Okay. When you choose gain margin is equal to 3, then the phase margin will be equal to 2, so pi by 3 means 60 degree. So, when you choose gain margin of a value 4, that time phase margin will be equal to pi by, so 4, 1 by 4, 3 by 4, so 3 by 8, pi 3 pi by 8 is giving roughly your 67.5 degree. So, what do we observe from here? With the choice of a gain margin of a value greater than 2. So, when a gain margin of a value greater than 2 is used, ultimately you design a PIE controller having a phase margin greater than 45 degree. So, either you choose gain margin or phase margin and design the PIE controller parameters. This is how the PIE controller parameters can be designed. Okay. Now, we will go to the design of the PD controllers using the phase and gain margins together. Instead of using either the phase margin condition or the gain margin conditions, I will use both criteria at a time and try to design the parameters of the PIE controller. PD controller will of course be designed using the technique we have already discussed earlier, where the derivative control parameter TD will be equated to theta by 2 and the remaining parameter KF is found from the expression 1 upon K root of 2 T 1 by theta. So, PD controller will be designed as usual using the earlier technique, whereas the PIE controller will be designed using some other technique now. So, design of the PIE controller using both phase and gain margins criteria at a time. Okay. So, we know that given a loop gain, the expressions for the phase and gain margins can be expressed as the phase and gain margin criteria give us the loop gain GC1, magnitude of the loop gain GC1 J omega G, G dash J omega G, magnitude will be 1 at the gate gain crossover frequency at which the phase of the loop will be angle GC1 J omega G, G dash J omega G will be equal to minus pi plus phi m. Similarly, when the loop gain G C 1 J omega p G dash J omega p magnitude is equal to 1 by the gain margin, at that time the phase angle will be minus pi. Okay? So, G C 1 J omega p G dash J omega p will be equal to minus pi. So, keep in mind the two frequencies, gain crossover frequency, phase crossover frequency, So, at different frequencies you have got different magnitude and phase angles for the loop gain. So, we have got four equations now. Now, assuming that omega g t I is larger than 1, omega p t I is greater than 1 and omega g tau is large compared to 1, omega p tau is large compared to 1, the four conditions can give us simpler expressions. Okay. And also using the formula for the arctan function, tan inverse as x is equal to pi by 2 minus pi by 4 x for all x greater than 1, it will be possible to find simpler expressions now given by the four equations. We have got four equations. When G C 1, G dash are substituted, they will yield us equations in the form of K K P is equal to omega G T 1 minus K K F theta by 2 G M K K P is equal to omega p t 1 minus k k f theta by 2 phi m, the phase margin is equal to pi by 2 minus 1 by omega g t I plus 1 by omega g tau minus theta omega g and pi by 2 minus 1 upon omega p t I plus 1 upon omega p tau minus theta omega p is equal to 0. So, these four equations can be obtained from the phase and gain margin criteria using these assumptions. Okay? So, I am not going to derive all these things in this lecture because it takes much time to find the final expressions beyond the scope of this lecture. Okay? So, that way I will write the final expression for the PIPD parameter when the four analytical expressions we have got are solved simultaneously. So, when you solve these four equations simultaneously, solution of the above four equations gives K p is equal to C 1 by k theta times T 1 minus k k f theta by 2 and T I is equal to tau by 1 plus C 2 by theta times tau, where C 1 is equal to 2 phi m plus pi gm minus 1 divided by 2 times gm square minus 1, and C 2 is equal to pi by 2 gm C 1 times 1 minus 2 gm C 1 by pi. Okay. So, this is how the parameters of the PI controller are designed using the phase and gain margin criteria. Okay. So, you get some horrible expressions because you have got 4 analytical expressions which are highly nonlinear in nature. Let us go to the simulation studies. We will have 2 simulation studies. In the first one, consider a higher order transfer function G s given by 2 upon s plus 1 to the power 4. So, the process dynamics is of higher order. The process model parameters and the PIPD controller parameters obtained using the choice of gain margin of 3.6 and phase margin of 30 degree are tabulated in the following table. Okay. So, in the following table, what you see for this process, the process model parameters, the first order plus dead time transfer function model parameter we have got the steady state gain k h 2, time constant t h 4.613 seconds and time delay theta h 1.773. And based on the k, t and theta, the PIPD controller parameters are estimated using either this formula, or we have got a number of formula, means for KPTI we have got this formula, or using this formula KFTD. So, we have got a number of formula for the PIPD controllers, where the PIPD controllers are estimated using the process model parameters k, t and theta. So, the estimated values for the PIPD controllers are given here, for the parameters of the PIPD controller are given here. Now, we have simulated the PIPD controller along with the plant in closed loop using unit step input as the reference input and a static load disturbance of magnitude 0.5 occurring at time t is equal to 40 seconds. So, when the PIPD controller are put in the loop for the system, what sort of result we get, we will see. So, we get a time response of this form. So, please see, this is the load response you have got and this is the time response you have got, and the responses are found to be satisfactory. Okay. Now, similarly, in the simulation 2, we have considered an unstable transfer function. Unlike the first simulation study, here we have an unstable first order plus dead time transfer function model given by G s is equal to k 4 e to the power minus 2 s upon 4 s minus 1, and with the choice of gain margin of 4.5 and phase margin of 60 degree, the PIPD controller parameters are estimated as KP is equal to 0.085, TI is equal to 1.879, KF h 0.5 and TD h 1.001. Then a simulation model has been developed. The PI controller parameters outright you can write, because you have got KP value as this and TI as this, whereas the PD controller parameters, you see carefully how I have found the PD controller parameters GC 2 s is equal to KF 1 plus TDS divided by 1 plus beta TDS. That gives you KF 1 plus beta TDS, okay, 1 plus beta will remain here TDS divided by 1 plus beta TDS, or that has been, so substitute the value of KF beta TD here and you get this PD controller in this form. Okay. To find the correct value for the PD controller, you have to use this expression. Now, the simulation results obtained from the PIPD controller are shown here. The time response for the unit step input is shown in the initial part, whereas the load response is shown in the latter part. Again, the static load disturbance, static load of magnitude 0.1, please keep in mind, of magnitude 0.1 occurs at time t equal to 40 seconds. So, the responses are found to be satisfactory. Let us summarize the lecture. A first order plus delay process model is estimated initially from two stages of relay tests. Using the gain and phase margins based tuning formula, parameters of the PIPD controllers are obtained. The proposed control technique enables one to retune controller settings as and when necessary to achieve enhanced performance of the closed loop. The method can easily be extended to control a variety of processes, especially for controlling for effective control of integrating and unstable processes. So, the method can find extensive use for integrating and unstable processes. Coming to the points to ponder, do we need PIPD controllers for controlling stable processes? Yes, the PIPD controllers can be used for stable processes, can be used for stable processes as the PD controller basically places the roots of the open loop stable process at suitable locations. Also, the PIPD controllers find extensive use in controlling, integrating and unstable processes. It can also be used for controlling stable processes. Thanks. Thank you.